You know what, guys? You know what? I am done. Okay? I am done. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I am Aris and today it's Sunday, so it's time for another POV street photography photo walk in rain. Today we're shooting with the Sony 7.3 and the Sony 50mm 1.8 and I'm super pumped because rain is one of my favorite conditions to shoot street photography in. I say that a lot, I say that about every condition really, but yeah, indeed, rain is one of my favorite ones. Also, it was a spare of the moment to choose the 50mm lens because obviously I could have used the Sony 85mm, but yeah, why not? I said, let's go with a 50mm, try to remember this focal length because the focal lengths are different and different focal lengths change massively the way you shoot out in the streets. So yeah, why not? Let's shoot with the actual 50mm today. Remember guys, hit the like button down below, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't done already. Comment, share, all of this good stuff and let's go out because I am really pumped. Hello from the voiceover, we are out on this fine rainy day with the Sony 7.3 and the Sony 50mm 1.8. A few words quickly for the settings I'm going to use today. First, I'm setting my aperture at f1.8 and I'm going to leave it there for the whole photoshoot for two reasons. First, I want to be able to get as much light as I can to the sensor so I don't have to increase my ISO too much. And second, because I like the softer look this aperture gives to the photos. I set my ISO at 250 and I am also going to leave it there for the whole photoshoot. The only thing I am going to play with today is the shutter speed. First shot, I went for a warm-up shot that in the end I ended up liking a lot. So we have this beautiful white tree in front of us and behind of it some windows covered by yellow plates. I thought that the combination of white and yellow would work nicely together. I made two shots, one focusing on the window in the back and one in the white flowers in the front. Also with these photos I'm debuting a new editing style I have been working on recently. Here they are. Here I had a spontaneous cut that I think worked really well. I caught a biker wearing a yellow coat for the rain passing in front of me. The camera with this lens didn't focus very fast and the biker ended up being out of focus in my frame. However, I think this shot works really well, having this nice yellow pop. Also, the first thing I loved immediately in this shot was the framing. What do you think? Top shot moment, this one is either the best or one of the best from this shoot. I will let you decide that in the comment section down below. In terms of the composition, here we have the lamps in a row that work beautifully in the upper right corner. We have the reflective pavement looking good and of course we have the girl with the umbrella, which is the main subject of the photo. Couple of details to look at this shot, we have the girl's shoes that are lit nicely and the little red dots in the background. I have made a night shot in this spot in the past. This is the first time I'm making a daylight shot though. So here I went for the reflections and the symmetries. A woman with a nice hat passed and I framed her as she was walking in between the bike on the left and the traffic light on the right. The reflection on the right hand side is almost perfectly symmetrical to the actual scene and I like it a lot. I also like that I caught the traffic light in the moment that both the red and the orange lights were on. Steps down the road and on the opposite sidewalk I found a really cool spot that works as it does only because of the rainy mood. Here we have the lanterns on the left hand corner and another traffic light on the right side. We also have the pointy part of the church across the road that works nicely with the mood of the shot. As subjects here I have used two people walking on the sidewalk and their reflections. One thing I want you to notice here is how the wet pavement and the road are actually making the shot. I camped here for quite some time waiting for the perfect subject. I think another highlight from this spot was this one here. Two girls holding umbrellas were walking side by side. As they were passing between the traffic light and the wall, one of them bended her umbrella backwards, ending up creating a very nice contrast between her black umbrella and the white umbrella of her friend. Then I saw a guy riding a bike with a really intense orange jacket waiting for the traffic light. He was casting a very nice reflection on the wet pavement. Also, I like that the red traffic light was doing the same, adding an extra interest to the shot. And last shot from this location, this is a very simple shot, but I liked it a lot for the harmony it radiates. So we have this beige storefront covered with some sort of beige pieces of paper from inside, then a girl with a beige coat passed blending to the scene. Moving towards the other side, another girl passed riding a bike. Her red scarf is really popping amongst all those earthly tones. I don't know, it is very simple, but it has something serene that I really enjoy. I don't know, have you figured it out yet? What is this thing I'm done with? There is a big, small but big change actually in my photos. Some of you, the more observant ones, probably have figured it out, but if you have, let me know down in the comments. I want to see if it's noticeable, because I think it is quite noticeable. Complete change of location now, I thought of walking around the graphic city center, which is full of pedestrian walkways. I thought that all the pavements would be reflective now due to the water. So I found this alley here that was reflecting all the buildings and the lights around, and I imagined a nice frame full of reflections. I camped here as well for quite a bit really, waiting for this special someone to pass by. The first highlight from this area was a man wearing a really intense red jacket holding an umbrella with red elements. Again, all this red really popped from these earthly tones of the scene. The next highlight was this shot here. This is kind of the opposite than the previous one. The frame was more or less the same, but the subject didn't pop from the frame so much. Her beige jacket merged with the surroundings. However, her skirt had a very nice muted red color that didn't pop, but looked in balance with the rest of the scene. Also, I got her while she was walking, capturing the whole extent of the skirt. Then I moved on and I stumbled upon a scene I didn't expect to capture today. So I have this series in which I'm photographing items left behind by people in weird positions and places. However, these items have to really stand out from their environment for some reason. One such reason could be that we have an excellent foreground-background separation, like this shot I took in Leicester last year. Another reason could be the lighting, like in this scene right here. Here we have a yellow vest left on this couch-like surface inside this corner shop. Next to it there is a cup of coffee. It is funny, but the light coming from the window feels as if it was placed there, just so it can focus on the vest and leave everything else in the darkness. Then I took a second shot trying to use the window on the right as a screen to another world. I wanted to capture some person or a scene that would contradict with the loneliness of the vest. So a couple passed, both walking under the same umbrella holding each other. I thought it made a nice contradiction. Having said that, I would like to walk past this place another time as well to see if I can capture any other more complicated scenes. In this next spot, I focused on one person with a beautiful black umbrella that had a distinct red line circling its base. In the first shot, I went for a horizontal composition, placing the woman in the right third of the image, framing the alley around her. I love the little flags in the top of the frame. I think they match nicely to the woman. In the second frame, the woman had passed by me, so I focused on the umbrella and I framed it in between the shops. I love the colors here. The red of the umbrella really pops. Next to it, there is a distinct aqua color that complements the red. The wall has a deep orange color I absolutely love. Overall, this is another one of my favorite frames from today. And for the last frame, I put a bicycle in the foreground, out of focus as a leading line, leading the eye towards the woman with the umbrella. Here, the colors were in general more muted, making the red bit of the umbrella really pop. And with that, my friends, let's go back to the office. Yeah, so the thing I'm done with is clarity. Guys, okay, I'm stopping using clarity. I'm stopping increasing this clarity slider. Me and in clarity, we are done. We are divorced. That's it. Well, actually, I'm still playing around with the clarity, but this time I'm moving it to the other side. I'm moving towards the left side. I'm decreasing clarity because I want to start getting this more soft feel to the photos. I want to start letting the photo give whatever it has to give without forcing something, because I feel like when I'm increasing the clarity slider, I'm actually trying to force the photo to be good. I think the best photos are the ones that don't need that. They don't need this extra super contrast weird thing. And I like the softness. I like what I see from other people. I'm inspired by other people to start giving a little bit of a softer feel to my photos. Having said that, I'm still increasing the clarity slider a bit in some cases and in a very specific way. But I'm not going to discuss that in this video today. I'm going to discuss that in a speed editing tutorial in the next couple of weeks. So make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell to see that, to not miss that, okay? Now, in terms of the 50mm focal length, I think, yeah, I've lost my touch because I haven't used it for so long, really, because I was stuck with the 85mm, so yeah, I kind of forgot how to shoot at 50mm. And of course I have used this lens on the Sony 6400, but on the Sony 6400 you get a cropped factor of 1.5, so again, with a 50mm it's like you're shooting with an 85mm. So the 50mm focal length is a special one, and it's different than either the 35 or the 85, because it's somewhere in the middle and it can get a little bit confusing. It's not too wide, but at the same time it's not too zoomed. So you have to find this sweet spot. You have to get closer to your subjects than when you're using the 85mm focal length, but at the same time you have to be a little bit further away than when you're using a 35mm focal length. But it's a really fun lens because you get this f1.8 aperture. It's a cheap lens, it's a budget lens, so it's accessible to many people. So I think it's worthwhile if people want to use it to make videos to show to everyone what are the kind of photos you can get with this particular lens. And also it's because I spent about a year of my life just shooting with a 50mm focal length, and then when I got the 85mm I left it on the side and I kind of forgot how to shoot with a 50mm, and I don't want to forget the skills I have acquired in the past. So it's good to take it out of the box every now and then and try it out on the streets and kind of try to remember all the things I've learned in the past with this lens. And that was all. If you liked the video, guys, please remember to hit the like button down below. Share this video with any of your friends that might be interested in videos like that. Comment any of your questions or anything else you want to say. If you don't know what to say, just say hi. Okay, guys, that was all. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, bye-bye.